Hey, welcome back to NieR Automata.
Hey, we'll quick save. And then we'll transport on over to the Flooded City. Because that is where plot is located. Oh, oops. My bad. Boop, 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 boop. Such nice music. So calming.
I do enjoy the music.
Dude, the music's great. Like, every song is the best song. You know, I should probably put on my good, like, chipset that's not specifically designed for races. That'd be smart.
Yes?
I remember I did that and I forgot to do it in my save. And I forgot to flip over. And I'm like, why am I doing so little damage? Oh, that's why. I have the ability to go fast and that's it.
Oh.
Circle
I'm just trying to, like, think of all possibilities of what 9S could have been up to, but
I don't think you're gonna guess it. I really don't.
I'm coming up with nothing. Was he potentially kidnapped by Eve? So what would you say is your favorite genre of games?
Oh, RPG. No doubt.
Like full on RPG or when is RPG mixed with things? Because this is technically an action RPG.
This is technically a character action game.
With RPG elements.
Yeah.
So like full on RPGs or RPGs mixed with other genres.
Honestly, I could take either or. Like, I love the RPG elements of building the character. That's where I come in. Like, in this case, you're not picking stats out. You're just like, alright, plug in chips. What extra numbers do I want here? Like, it doesn't drastically change your playstyle.
Attention, this is Carrier Blue Ridge. Bridge 2. Requesting support from any friendly units in range.
Unlike Dark Souls, where, like, the difference between
heavy fire from the
magic
enemy.
And using,
our escort ship has taken damage and is unable to engage. We're currently resisting with all remaining support fighters, but we can't hold them off for long. I repeat, this is Carrier Blue Ridge 2. We need immediate backup from any available
Android
forces.
I'm more for platformers and somewhat Metroidvania, since I do like the whole exploration aspect of a good Metroidvania.
I mean, that's part of the reason why I like Dark Souls 2, is because of that level design and the connectivity of a Metroidvania that
it's not for. Although I played... Oh, what was it? Like, Witch and the 66 Mushrooms? That was a decent Metroidvania, but
I'm picking up a large scale enemy
it
inbound.
Was
looks
half
to be
cryptic at the same time. So I remember spending a good half hour going, where do I go? Before finally looking up on YouTube, and you had to jump into lava that up until that point would hurt you. And I'm like, how is I supposed to know that lava doesn't hurt me anymore?
Yeah?
Yeah, because there's only lava in that one area.
Enemy aerial unit destroyed. Revert
I would
to area
say
Wait,
that
I'm still picking up a large enemy presence. Didn't I kill that already?
These...
What on... If it's that big, we should be able to see it.
I do... Nah. Is this a new boss?
Well, that
no, it's not. It's this thing, remember?
Now I remember.
Is that a machine? It's freaking huge.
Now I remember it. It's like some giant whale or something.
Whale fish thing, yeah.
Yeah, but I would say all in all, that game had
crap. It's blocking
very
interesting with the MP
puzzles.
Blasts. We've got to find another way to damage.
Well, I was gonna say one of the other games where you talked about playing was Dragon's Dogma, and that one is definitely.
Operator 210 to 9S. Command has decided to stage a direct satellite laser strike on the hostile. We need you to destroy the enemy EMP generator so we can lock onto the target. EMP generator. Sending the coordinates to your map
like,
now.
Like, they took the idea of, what is it called?
EMP generator target confirmed.
Shadow of the Colossus.
Marking on map.
Colossus.
Proposal.
To, like,
destroy the generator
another
quickly.
Level completely. Where the monster's not as big, but you're still climbing it. And it's way more mobile.
I really haven't played Shadow of the Colossus. So, would the not Colossuses in that game be about the size of this? No, never mind. I think this boss here is about the size
of
a typical Colossus.
Is a lone sighting 320 years.
So how?
Upon
like,
reaching land, the unit unleashed a devastating electromagnetic wave attack. All resistance fighters in the vicinity were annihilated.
Okay,
no,
this thing reaches land.
This thing stands up.
Affirmative.
Like, while it's laying down like this, yeah, some of the Colossi might be about that size or smaller.
And in Dragon's Dogma, they are about this size, or are they smaller?
Oh, they are smaller. Like, literally, some of them are human size. For instance, like, you know what harpies are, right?
Yeah, like, bird women that like scream a lot.
Yeah, they're like bird women, but in that game you can literally grab onto their legs and fly with them.
Oh, so you can for a better choice of words, befriend them and use their abilities to your benefit?
No, not even. You do that while you're fighting them.
Oh.
Like you can grab them. They're trying to fly away. And they'll bring you along with them. or like in the case of a, let's just say like a griffin, for example. You can grab onto the wings of a griffin, right? And you're being flapped around. Like, as you're holding those wings.
Mm-hmm.
Confirmed elimination
like,
in of electromagnetic
of Colossus,
interference.
There's a decent
Stand
argument
by
to be
for
made
incoming
that that's
satellite
more
laser
platform
strike.
Than anything else. Because half the time you're like platforming on the Colossus.
Ooh, right in the blowhole.
Oh, come on! It's got an electromagnetic barrier over its whole body?
Like, there's one Colossus that has, like, a weird stone sword on, right? Like, they'll
having
swing the sword,
over
arm,
there?
The sword arm down,
Are
and
you
it'll
Yorga?
Take them a while to bring it back up. And you hop onto that sword and start
Hunter
climbing
squadron
your way up
Squadron deploying
it.
Out of North 12C Defense HQ. I'm the commanding officer, 4B. Don't worry, we'll take it from here.
Aim for the blowhole! Aim for the blowhole!
Let's leave this area to the reinforcements. I have an idea. You and I should meet up at the spot I just marked.
Nine S. Why is there candles, chocolate, and flower petals on a bed at the spot you marked? No reason to be.
I think the question would be, what is chocolate?
Well, they know what fish is.
Well,
so,
yeah, fish is an animal.
But wouldn't they be able to do like research in the
this
like the snacks? Doesn't the Yorha have vending machines?
Let's try
no.
for a more direct approach.
Direct? Oh, right.
They
That's
disguise
right.
stuff as a vending machine.
Lay down some fire
machine,
in its stupid mouth.
But they don't have to like supply anything for those vending machines.
Come on! At least one of the vending machines must be a real vending machine.
I doubt that. Besides, at this point, it wouldn't even work, and anything inside would probably be disintegrated to shit. Like, it's been a few hundred years since there were humans on the planet.
Well, I'm just disappointed that Yorha doesn't know the joy of chocolate.
To me!
It's an imp!
We gotta bail, 2B. This is bad.
Oh, wow. I forgot how big that was.
Yep, way bigger than most of the Colossi. There's maybe one that's close.
Are you alright, 2B?
I think it's the last one.
Oh, it's Pascal.
That enormous machine is an ancient weapon. It was designed to help annihilate the androids, but it wound up going out of control. I was part of the machine's network when it happened, so I remember it. The moment it reached land, it went berserk and began attacking everything in sight. No one could figure out how to stop it. We eventually marooned it deep in the ocean. But it seems to be searching for a way back. Huh.
Hey, 2B. I think I have another idea. You keep
this
thing right where it is, okay?
What?
Please, 2B. This is gonna work.
Off he goes.
And now we see where he's going.
2B, I'm going to see if we can use those missiles back on the shore. But I need you to destroy the EMP unit on that thing's back. Otherwise, they're just going to go off course.
On.
That is a stand with us. We should murder him right now.
Why?
Because he's abandoning the mission. That's what Pod tells 2B during this trip.
Even more proof that 2B is secretly an E-unit!
I don't even think the pod would be aware.
Because
if 2B herself isn't aware, I highly doubt the pod's aware. Because that was one of your theories at one point.
The pod is an E unit.
The pod's a... That's pretty good. I like that idea. The pod just comes in. Oh man, I'm sorry. Like, he starts talking like a normal human being. You know, you fucked up. Now I gotta break my cover.
It seems that you have discovered something that you shouldn't have about me. So...
Just grows like an evil mustache and starts twirling it.
What? Do you expect me to talk?
Activate
no,
missile.
Mr. S.
Gets a top hat,
you die.
Gets a top hat.
Launch ability confirmed.
Fire!
He somehow sprouts a monocle.
Oh. I have a... kind of...
I didn't think this would be so hard to control.
Alert. Obstacle
I have a kind of a
speed is not recommended.
Cool.
I'm aware, thank you.
A slightly crazy James Bond theory, but it kind of makes sense. I'm guessing that 007 and James Bond are synonymous. That 007 is James Bond. So when somebody becomes 007, they also
organize
become James Bond.
That's members at
that could explain why James Bond was played by so many actors
to be
over the years.
Menace. I'm pretty sure that was confirmed, that it's a title.
Don't die on me.
No, 007 is the title.
No,
but...
they both are the title, though.
Oh!
That's what
the
I thought was confirmed.
Held sway over enormous strength.
I just thought 007 was the title.
Broken.
Oh, cool!
He spent his long days hurting those around him. He tried his best to be good and kind. But despite his efforts, things never seemed to turn out. They told him he was unwanted.
Oh, poor whale.
They abandoned him in the deep, dark ocean.
He had a teardrop.
And from the cold at the bottom of the sea, he cried out, Mother, 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 Mother.
Oh, I'm a sad whale in the bottom of the ocean. And that's all I have to my song. Because I'm not good at improv singing.
Pods.
This is Tactical Support Unit Pod 042, assigned to 2B.
This is Tactical Support Unit Pod 153, assigned to 2B.
And this is a commentary on what just happened.
Pods often participate in the same battles. Exchanging our situational data would theoretically allow us to plan combat strategies in a more efficient manner. Proposal. Data should be transferred regularly between Pod 042 and Pod 153.
Analysis. This idea is sound. Proposal accepted. Records will be organized in time for the next situational exchange.
Hello. This is Pod 153. Welcome to my commentary track for NieR Automata.
Is this Hacking Space? How did I... I found myself in a bizarre memory storage area, stretching as far as I can see. It's a maze, a labyrinth, a massive interconnected network. I've never seen anything like it. It must have been created by the machines. So then, what am I doing here? I am 9S. That's all I can remember. Large portions of my memory may have been destroyed. What if I forget everything? My memories? Myself? My...
Love for 2B!
Okay, calm down. Calm down. Just follow the emergency manual and execute the memory recovery program. The recovery program begins to fill in the blanks in my memory. They drift back, like missing letters, filling out a word. The bunker, Tubi's plan. A colossal machine life form. A last resort missile strike. Preservation mode was activated at the moment of the blast. It halted most of the safeties the network had in place. Wait, it must have been that EMP blast. Hooked me up to the machine network, too. It took a while, but the recovery program managed to restore most of my memory functions. However, I still can't establish a link to my body. Well, guess there's nothing else to do but examine the surroundings.
Memory space.
Close enough. It looks like the machines gathered and stored a lot of info in here. It all seems pretty random at first, but on closer inspection, I learn how it's all connected. There are a variety of entries, such as data on human history and philosophy. But what's really strange are... Oh, whoops.
Something.
It's some weird shit about 2B. In the politics category are records of the machine's own governmental endeavors. They tried to sort things at absolute monarchies, republics, democracies... And that wasn't all. They also engaged in other scholarly pursuits such as philosophy, mathematics, science, and social criticism. It's like the network.
Also cat videos. Lots and lots of cat videos. Why did humans like cat videos so much?
It's like the network was copying every possible human behavior and discipline. Almost as if... Imitating humans? How would they do that? I dive deeper into the records. I find no indication of the machines creating new cultures or values. They only imitate human behavior. The strange thing is, if a unit fails, it fails in the exact same way every time. For example, if a machine forms a dictatorship that eventually collapses, it won't try a new form of government. It just forms a new dictatorship. Or if it plants crops and they die, it'll just try the same thing again. And again. And again. And again. They keep performing the same behaviors. They don't ever learn. When it comes to combat, the machines show overwhelming adaptive behavior and evolutionary speed. So why do they insist on imitating humans? And more specifically, why do they imitate their failures? It's almost as if the objective is failure itself. I sense a change in the data. Some kind of movement. I hone my perception and hold my breath. I hear something. A distant voice. I am now all androids. There's something there. Something clearly intelligent.
What's the other way?
Talking? This way?
Yeah, I thought... Oh, there's another path. Oh, that's
the... It's a dead end.
Hold on just a second. I believe we're at the end of an episode. So before you go on, next time on NieR Automata, we are finally learning what may be up with the machines. You probably know, and you will probably laugh so hard when I'm like, so that's what it is. Right?
Just gonna hold back the laughter.
All right, see everybody next time.